In this video, I'm going to show you the only node structure you'll ever need. Okay, so we have this clip of a guy that's going to go for a swim. I just grabbed this off ArtGrid, and I'm going to show you the only node structure you will ever need. So just to show you, my color management is Davinci. It's Rec 709 2.4. This output color space is there if it's for broadcast. It all depends on where your deliverable is, but let's say you are grading something for broadcast. Your output would be 2.4. I always work in the timeline color space, Davinci wide gamut. First step, we're going to add a color space transform. This footage is red. Where are you? There you go. Red and red. I'm going to change it into DaVinci wide gamut. DaVinci intermediate. So red's going in. It converts it to DaVinci. Second step, create another CST. We're going to go DaVinci. We want it to be Rec 709 and then gamma 2.4 because that's the deliverable. This deliverable can change. This is just the standard if it's for broadcast. This CST, so it's red DaVinci. We don't want it to change any of the tone mapping. So we say none. This tone mapping, you can play around, but I like DaVinci because it gives a good roll off the highs and the lows. CST. All our grading is going to happen here. When it is DaVinci wide gamut, this is the most data. This is where the magic is going to happen. A normal project would look like this. You add the CSTs. This is Rec 709. This is actually how it was shot on the day. Now we add one. I'm just going to use my Stream Deck to add serials here. One, two, three. One, two, three, four. Then one. And I'm going to add parallels. One, two, three. You can add parallel by right-clicking and just say add parallel. I'm just using my Stream Deck. I'm going to label all of these. This one is exposure. This one is balance, contrast, saturation. These four are your primaries. These are your secondaries. This node structure is a basic node structure. I mean, you can add as many as you want, but this is a very good spot to start from. Now, your secondaries could be, I don't want to reset that. I want to do label. And I want to go temp. Maybe this guy is texture pop for skin. Your secondaries could be anything you feel like the shot needs. How I start every project, this is the basis I work off. After the CST, this is where we work on the look. So before we do anything here, you got to get the look dialed in. And then you start adjusting clip by clip. I'm going to stay inside of DaVinci for this. You'll find a lot of plugins, Dehancer, Filmbox, anything like that. A lot of people use to kind of create their look. You can also use the curves, which I'll show you in a second. Keep this very simple. And I'm going to go to the Luts in DaVinci. The one that's super popular, a lot of people use, is Rec 709 Kodak 2383. Put that in there, and your footage looks terrible because this LUT, it doesn't want 709 2.4. You have to do an extra step in here. We'll close that guy. You gotta be smaller, man. There you go. Going to add an extra node, and it's going to be another CST. Remember, this guy turns DaVinci in Rec 709 2.4. This would be 709. It's coming from 709 2.4. And we want to change it to 709 Cineon film log. Look at that. I'm going to turn it on and off. That's 709. This is with the film look. 709 film look. Let's say we kind of like that. Maybe. Let's say we want to decrease the effect of this film look. We just want a bit of it, but not the entire thing. A normal way to do that would be to go to the key and then reduce the gain. But you'll see a problem with this. We reduce the gain, reduce the effect of this node, it's going back to Cineon film log, which we don't want. If you say zero, the image looks bad. It's because it's going back to Cineon film log. So what we can do here is if we reset this, we take these two and we create a compound node. We'll just turn that on and off. This is with the film look. Let me just label it. It's Kodak 2383. Now, if we reduce the gain, it's actually going back to 2.4, and that's exactly what we want. So if you ever use this technique with the film looks, I definitely put it in a compound node and it gives you more flexibility. So I'm going to park this around here. Turn on and off, and I like the look. I like the feeling, I like the look. Now I go into the primaries on a clip by clip basis. I'm looking at my parade, HDR. So exposure, let's go into the HDR tool. Let's put it here, nice and bright. Nothing's clipping. It's a nice roll off. That roll off is actually because of this, which is nice. Next one is balance. A lot of people have a problem understanding what balance is. It just means we want this to kind of be in the middle. And how we do that is look at the color wheels and you go to offset. I'm going to use my panel and you'll see me move that there. I'm going to make it a bit cooler on and off. So this is warmer. I'm going to go a bit cooler. That's the look that I want. Contrast. There's a few ways of doing contrast. It's totally up to you. I really like the offset gain method where you just use offset and gain. So I'm pushing down with the offset now. I'm pulling up with the gain on and off, on and off. Nice and blue and contrasty. And then lastly, I go saturation. Different ways of doing saturation. It's up to you. I like the HDR one. Gives me a bit more, it's a bit more refined. It's not as strong. And I'm going to leave it there. So these are the primaries, on and off. Off, on, off, and on. Now, if I want to change anything else, I can do temperature, texture. I mean, you can do whatever you really want. But this is the structure. Only structure you'll need for any type of project. As I said, this is a good base. If you want to add on new parallels, more nodes, it's up to you. The main thing to know is that in this type of color management, where you have a CST at the start and at the end, it gives you a lot of control over the input and the output and where you are grading. And you always want to grade majority of the time in the middle where DaVinci wide gamut. This is the information you're dealing with here. This is one way of doing it. Let's reset all of this. I'm going to start over and still use the structure, but I'm not going to use a film look. I am going to delete that. And now we are back at Rec 709, how the shot was originally shot, like on the day, was shot like this. Now what I'm going to do is increase the exposure. I feel like it was shot pretty dark. It needs to be here. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this node as a look. And instead of using a film look or a plugin or anything like that, I'm going to use the curves. So this is also another way of doing it. I'm going to go on red. I'm going to add default anchors. I usually like adding subtle color in the low end and the high end. I don't like adding color in the mids because that's where the skin sits and it starts looking strange. That's a personal preference for me. Let me play around with this a bit. Let's go down here. Go to the greens, add anchors. Oh, that looks bad. Let's go to the blue, add anchors. And now this is totally up to you. Completely up to you what you like and what your preference is. If I turn this on and off, very subtle. Let's make it a bit more exaggerated so you can see. Maybe do it like this. So you can definitely see here in the highlights. Well, that's where the green and blue is. You'll see here. And now that's off and that's on. So this, is this look great? No, it's pretty bad, but it gives you an idea. This is where you create that look and that feel. It doesn't have to be exactly what you want in the shot because we're going to still do primaries here and secondaries, but this is like the DNA that's going to be on your entire project. Once you are happy with this guy, we do exactly the same. We go back like we did at the exposure. And I want to put it there. Balance, go to the vector scope. I'm going to play with the offset and the color wheels there. Play with contrast, play with saturation until I'm happy. Let's go this balance. Maybe his skin looks a bit rough here. So I'm going to balance for the skin. I want him to look like the Incredible Hulk. There we go. Let's say I'm happy with that. That's going to be my hero shot. That's how I graded it. That's how I created the look. And then I'm going to go through all the clips. Once you understand this process of the CST, CST inside of it, that's where you do most of the heavy lifting. And then you create the look after this conversion, you'll understand it completely. It's kind of like you have to work backwards in a way. So you do the CST, CST, then you create the look feeling, then you go back to the primaries with the exposure, balance, contrast, saturation, primary adjustments, secondary adjustments, and then you're on your way. If you understand this concept, you can use it for every single project that you have.